You got on the show in part because of Dana Carvey, right? Dana Carvey got...
Well, Dana and I knew each other from the stand-up circuit, and Dana was also renting a room over the garage in this house I was renting with some other comics in the Hollywood Hills.
Yeah.
When he came down from San Francisco, he would stay there. And we would kind of jam in the driveway on, you know, with different kind of character stuff. I wasn't a character impressionist or anything, you know, I just did stand-up.
Yep.
But Dana, of course, was into all that.
Seemed like that was his big thing.
Yeah. So Dana got the show that summer of 86, and they start in the fall.
Yep.
So he goes to New York. I'm dating Jan Hooks at the time. We were friends for about 6 years, and then we started dating, which is the best way to do it.
Yeah.
But that didn't last.
She was on the show at that point?
She was not on the show.
Not on the show.
I was excited for Dana and for Jan because they were up for Saturday Night Live. Dana had it already. Jan was up for it, sure to get it. And I'm reading Backstage Live, Saturday Night Live, and excited for them. Never thinking I would ever be on that show because I didn't really even have the representation to get me an audition. And I didn't do characters. I never did an improv. I wasn't brought up in the improv ranks. And so Dana calls me from New York that summer. And he goes, hey, I think they're still looking for one more cast member. I told them about you, and I think they might want to see your tapes. I'm out at Lorne Michaels' house right now. I'm in the back room.
And calling you kind of.
Yeah, he is, yeah. He goes, guess who's in the kitchen? Chevy Chase and Paul Simon. I said, you're kidding me. And he goes, no. But anyway, I'll let you know about I send him my tapes, and a week later he calls me. He's back out at Lorne Michaels' house. Back out at Lorne Michaels' house. Guess who's in the kitchen? Dan Aykroyd. You're kidding me. I think they like your tapes. Really, Dan Aykroyd's in the kitchen? Yeah. And so they flew me in. They flew me in for an audition. And I never thought I would get it because, you know, I'm a stand-up comic. And I'm flying in with like so many people. I thought it would just be me and a couple other people because it was one part. And it seemed like the whole plane was full of people
going to audition.
Great improv people that I knew from the Groundlings and Second City, you know, from seeing them. Even the pilot came out of the cockpit. Hey, you guys think this is funny for my audition?
Right.
And I get there and I'm the only one that's not nervous because I'm not going to get the show. But, you know, I go in and I audition at Studio 8H where they shoot the show.
Yeah.
And I'm in front of Lorne Michaels and Dennis Miller and Nora Dunn, who was a leftover from, you know, the show before, the year before. Dana, John Lovitz. And I just do like some of my stand-up that I did on The Tonight Show. And some of the characters that Dana and I used to do together in the driveway. And I left thinking, well, you know, that was a fun trip.
That was fun.
Yeah.
I could tell people about this one day, right?
Yeah. Yep. And then I get home, and like a week later, I'm meeting with Lorne Michaels at my manager's office, and he talks for about an hour about Saturday Night Live, and I'm just kind of nodding. And he offers me a job as a writer and a feature player. He excuses himself to go to the restroom, when he's gone, my manager, who was also his manager, he says, let's tell Lauren we'll think about it over the weekend, you know. And I'm like, are you nuts?
Are you kidding? Who does that?
Yeah.
Right.
So it was almost like it was planned out by these guys.
Right.
You know, in hindsight, now that I knew that he managed both of us. Lauren comes back. Well, what do you think? And I said, Lauren, let me think about it over the weekend. And he said, all right, well, you think about it over the weekend, and we'll see you in New York on Monday.